A match cut is an editing technique to show a connection and meaning between two scenes, and it's given us some of the most memorable moments in cinema. In animation and motion graphics, we can use it in the same way. Once you understand it, you can use it to make more impactful or even seamless transitions. You can use it to make your boring elements feel more interesting and just add a ton of production value overall. And I'm going to show you exactly how. A match cut works by having something match between two scenes that are cut together, usually either the subject or the motion. One way is to have two visually similar objects in an environment that is different, where the composition is similar. There, the subjects match. Or you can have the motion match and the subject changes, like in 2001 A Space Odyssey. We see the advancement in technology from a bone tool to a spaceship. It is the perfect summary of the themes of the movie. We've got the whole relationship between man and technology in just one editing choice. But even without loading your storytelling shotgun with ideas and context and firing it point blank at the audience with a cut like this, we can exploit this technique to make even something with no substance seem interesting. It is the perfect solution when you don't have enough time or budget to make a big, crazy transition. Okay, here we've got two scenes that aren't connected by anything. Just a regular cut. And there's nothing wrong with a simple cut. Despite my initial impressions, great motion design isn't just a series of thrilling transitions one after another. Sometimes a cut is the best tool to tell your story. But when it's not, we can spice things up to connect their motion. So let's just animate the scale of these two comps. So the first one, we're going to animate it going from 100% to 105% just before the cut. So it's zooming in as we cut. And let's go into the graph editor and really accentuate the easing there. So we ease out of that first keyframe and really accelerate into that second one. And then do the same for the start of the second clip. Again, going from 100 to 105%, but in this one, we're gonna really ease into that second frame. So it's accelerating out of the cut. Now let's look at them. Now this holds your attention much better than this. It keeps the pace up and it's just a great way to elevate scenes without too much work. Now, if you are gonna do this, please be mindful and please be subtle. The 5% I used here maybe is even overkill, because if you're not careful, you're gonna end up with a project that looks like this. Which is fine if your TikToks and whatever attention span corroding media format comes our way next to just shock our eyes open long enough for them to slip an ad in there. But there is a reason why they don't edit films like this. Now, scale is one way to animate a match cut. You could use position as well, which is perhaps even more common. You can use rotation and any other property that you can think of. It's the same principle. One motion carries over from one scene to the next. And you can, of course, vary the speed. It doesn't need to be the same speed going in and coming out of the cut either. But that will be determined by what you're making. So here's how I've used it in my work.
What is Goon?
In this personal project I made explaining Australia's favorite boxed wine, I used a lot of match cuts. So let's take a look at this section.
Inspired by Australia's oldest drinking vessel, the pouch. Today, Goon is enjoyed by Australians of all ages, helping to keep the nation's pride up and perception down.
All right, this transition here. Here we're just going from a full screen of yellow and then scaling down the kangaroo. No match cut there. But here we cut from the kangaroo's pouch to the Goon sack. Now the Goon sack is a metallic bag filled with the cheap wine, and it's often taken out of the box and drunk upside down in this fashion. And for this transition, we've got the motion coming up to the left as we follow the pouch shape. And you can even see there's, I think, one or two frames beforehand I've even swapped out to the metallic sack here to just make it a little bit smoother. Then within the next pouring scene, we match cut between all of the heads to show the passing of time as our drinker ages, matching the subject. And there's also a subtle rotation to match the motion between all of them as well as they tilt their head back. And then in the next scene, there is about a two-frame wipe in between these two scenes, but it functions essentially as a cut. I did add that wipe going vertically downwards just so it matched the VO saying perception down.
Helping to keep the nation's pride up and perception down. When you can...
So here I'm matching the composition, no real motion matching here. But to add a bit of secondary animation, I've also added the coins bouncing as if they're reacting to the transition, as if the cut happening has somehow affected the physics of this world. And that's just really here saying, hey, look at this, things are being contrasted in this scene. Now, in some of these, we are kind of pushing the edge of what it means to be a match cut and what is actually a fully formed shape transition. But a match cut does kind of have a blurry edge depending on how much extra stuff you put on top of it. And I really think if you are wanting to create a fully formed shape morphe transition, starting with a match cut is really a great place to start. And then you can just add elements on top and make it more intricate and more connected between the two scenes. So like this literal match cut, a match and a sword that I use in my animation course. And no, this is not a subtle plug for my animation course. It's not subtle at all. So shameless plugging aside, my course does have 2 full weeks of lessons for match cuts and transitions because I do think they are some of the most challenging but also most rewarding things in animation. And from the first of those lessons, the one just on match cuts, the students have created some amazing assignments that I'd like to break down a bit because they are great examples. Phillip Zhang created this one with a beautiful minimal design. So let's look at how the subtle motion ties together each scene. So starting with a Newton's cradle and the ball swinging left to right. And as soon as it hits that ball on the right, we cut here and we see that motion continue, going from left to right like this. And then it swings back to the left, and as it comes back to the right here, that motion is continued. That swing up and to the right is the start of this flower growing. And then the flower head detaches, and as it does, it swings down to the left and reconnects that motion right back at the beginning with the swinging ball in the Newton's cradle. It is such a clever application of a match cut. I think it is beautiful. Campion K created this one, and just look at how this tells the story of making a cake just using match cuts. This is so clever how we follow through the creation of this cake through just one motion that shows all of the process. And what I really love about this is that it's not just one motion, which it could have been, of ingredients falling from top to bottom. The motion changes to match what's happening. So the ingredients are coming in, they're pouring, they're stirring, they're mixing, and they all manage to seamlessly be connected, which is not an easy task. It is really expertly done, and I love this sequence in the oven. It breaks up the pace so nicely. And then them falling into the cookie jar, transitioning back to the bowl at the beginning, I love it. And Neil Cocklin created this awesome cycling match cut that uses composition, scale, and rotation to match the motion. This is wonderful. I love how Savan used a match cut for the basis of this transition with this bird. Owen McKinder created this wonderfully grim Halloween themed match cut that adds just a ton of impact, especially with the sound design as well. And Mikhail matched the swinging motion with 3D rotation as well for even more of a matching motion. And I love the subtle touch of the antenna flying off in the second scene. That is perfect. Now these are all really successful examples, but one of the most important factors of whether your match cut is successful is to how well it is anticipated. What animation is happening immediately before that transition? And if you want to know how to do that most effectively, you'll want to check out this next video.